We have reporters on the scene, multiple eyewitness accounts coming in. We're going to get to all of that and stay with this live coverage. Let's bring in Annie Puller, our reporter now. Annie, people there obviously in deep shock. The centre, as we know it, is still locked down inside. People have been evacuated to the areas around you. It is a shocking scenario. Just describe what you're learning there, please.
Yeah, Michael, I've got to say it is a scene of sheer terror here at Bondi this afternoon. I've just had reports in that we're hearing up to four people have possibly lost their lives in what many have described to me as a stabbing rampage which took place on level four of the Westfield just after 4 o'clock this afternoon. Many people have told me that they saw this man armed with a machete making his way through several floors, and you can only imagine the reaction that was triggered in those people. They immediately ran into businesses, locked themselves in storerooms. Many told me that they hid under tables because they had no idea what was happening. I want to bring in now Rowan, because you were inside the centre, Rowan. Yeah. You saw this man armed. Talk me through what was happening.
So I was shopping the centre. I was just walking past the gym, actually, and I could see people running around on the level below us. And so we kind of all looked down to see what was happening and what was going on down there. And I had my phone out, obviously, as we all do these days, and I saw, running past the boosters, everyone sprinting back, this guy with a knife running towards people, running up to people with his knife. And so we then ran into the gym to try and shelter. And we were helping close the gym doors when we heard multiple gunshots. It sounded like multiple gunshots go off on the level below. And so then everyone kind of just ran back into the gym at that time to try and shelter. And then we were in there for probably 15 or 20 minutes at least. And then we got moved onto the roof where we were sheltering up there for another, you know, 20 minutes or 30 minutes.
The video that you've shown me of that man is absolutely terrifying. You can see quite a large knife in his arm.
Yeah.
What were people doing around him? What were they saying?
I think it was just disbelief, to be honest. Everyone was a bit in shock, like, this doesn't happen in Australia, right? And I think the moment that you heard the gunshots, it felt a little bit removed. You know, a knife is not an immediate threat to you when you're a floor away. But hearing gunshots is a completely different story, and I think that really triggered a lot of people, because no one knew where they were coming from, and as I said, it's just not something you expect to go through in Australia.
We're hearing that those gunshots were actually police who shot down this man armed with a machete. You, like so many others, did the right thing, hid in those stores, locked the doors. What was running through your mind in that moment?
I don't know, to be honest. I'm trying to think back. It was only like an hour ago, but I think just disbelief and thinking, like, how does this happen here? And, you know, what's your next immediate step? Where do I go? Do I, you know, the gym, there's no out of the gym. Do I go hide in the change room? Do I, you know, try and get out and go out onto the roof or something? So it's really just, what is that immediate next step to stay safe?
Knowing that our man has been apprehended now, how does that make you feel? Are you somewhat relieved?
Definitely relieved. I think you can see around us the huge police operation, but it definitely felt like when we were on the roof, there were not a lot of police around at that time. And so it did feel a bit like, what is actually happening? Is it under control? And it was only when the tactical unit came and, you know, we had to put our hands up and they frisked us and then escorted us out of the building, it kind of felt like, okay, you know, it's probably all over now. So,
and I'm guessing at that point in time, you had no idea how long you were going to be locked inside there for.
Correct. And no idea actually what had happened or if anything was still happening, because you're obviously reading reports and you're seeing, is there a hostage involved? Is there, you know, still someone on the loose? And when we were on the roof, the tactical unit came running past us at one point to go search the car park. And so just like, oh, okay, is it still going? Is there something still going on? So,
I mean, you alluded to this earlier, but this is not something that we see every day on the streets of Bondi. I mean, how do you feel knowing that this has happened inside a Westfield where thousands of people come every day to do their shopping, caught up in just sheer terror?
I think it's pretty unbelievable, right? But it does make me incredibly grateful for the sort of protections that we have in Australia, and the fact that this is a completely unusual scenario, and hopefully one I and anyone else here never has to go through again.